Well, it's Sunday, about to get ready to head to the gym. Just got back from church. So while I'm getting dressed, I'm gonna make me a protein shake back here, get me a little protein in my system and stuff, get something on my stomach before I take my NO Explode. Can't do that on an empty stomach, kinda upsets my stomach a little bit if I do too much of it. Pre-workout on a completely empty stomach, so yeah, because I ate breakfast at like 8 o'clock this morning. That was, you know, 4.5 hours ago, so well, I'm gonna make this up, get changed, and I'll see y'all at the gym in a few minutes. Got my NO Explode, heading down the road now. Well, guys, that's it. Another workout done. The second day, felt pretty good. That leg workout is something else, though. I know I'm gonna be sore tomorrow, but you know, I've done some stretching and stuff like that to help relieve the soreness a little bit. Drinking plenty of fluids. Gonna go home and feed myself right. I got plenty of chicken and broccoli and protein shakes, all that stuff. And got my Got my creatine, my pixie sticks. Go ahead and take my creatine now. Let that sit in there and then get the pixie sticks while I'm talking to you guys. Uh,
while I'm closing this out and cooling down, I want to talk to you guys about something. This is something that I've heard people talk about, you know, and it's true to some extent, but, you know, you'll hear somebody say something like, well, I'm just going to use squats for an example. You know, they'll say, oh, I can't do squats. I've got bad knees, or, you know, I can't do this and that because it hurts. Well, I want to get into that a little bit. So I've noticed this whenever I'm doing my squats is that I do get some pain in my knees. But it's not because I'm doing things incorrectly. It's not because I've got bad knees, which, you know, technically I do. But, you know, a lot of it is the fact that the frequency and, you know, volume that I'm doing right now is something I'm not used to. So it's gonna cause a little bit of inflammation of the connective tissue there. But, you know, unless you've had some, like, major knee surgery or major knee injuries that you never really fully recuperated from, you know, the bad knees, bad back, you know, stuff like that, it doesn't really apply. You just have to get your body accustomed to the workout that you're trying to do. Now, me, on the other hand, you know, I have a small knee injury that did not require surgery that I had a few years ago. But, you know, I have rheumatoid arthritis. You know, I was diagnosed with this almost 4 years ago at the age of 32. And, you know, this causes inflammation in my knees, my ankles, my hips, my, you know, every joint that I have in my body, I get inflammation there. And I wake up a good deal of every single day not feeling great. It takes me a while to get up and around. And I spend, you know, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week in some level of discomfort. And some days are worse than others. Say, whenever I have a flare-up, you know, I might, you know, feel absolutely terrible and can't get out of bed. And, you know, but the fact of the matter is, I don't let that get me down. I come in here and get my workout in. So, you know, the whole attitude of no excuses, I do buy into that. There should not be really any excuses. But also, you know, look at that. There shouldn't be that within reason. Yeah, there's going to be some reasons why you can't come in here, you know, and work out as hard as somebody else. Whether it be, you know, whether it be an age thing, whether it be, you know, recovering from an injury, or maybe you're already hurt and you don't need to be pushing yourself beyond what that energy or that injury can allow you to do. But, you know, guys, just, you know, look at me. I'm 35 years old. You know, I work a full-time job. I also go to college on campus. Not anything online. I've got a family. You know, I've got other responsibilities. You know, and I have a somewhat debilitating and degenerative, you know, disease that causes me pain, causes inflammation, and, you know, For somebody else, you know, it might cause them to not want to get up, not have the mental drive to get up and do this. But, you know, I try not to use that as an excuse to not push myself. You know, I have goals. I had goals before. I was diagnosed with RA, and I'm not going to let the RA stop me from achieving those goals. So I just tell you guys, or, you know, whatever your situation is, you know, really truly assess yourself and ask yourself if any excuse or reason you're giving for not pushing yourself 110%, is it legitimate? You know, is it a really good reason to not want to push yourself? Or are you just selling yourself short because maybe you're lazy, or, you know, and I don't want to offend nobody with that, but, you know, just, you know, maybe that's what it is. Maybe there's a certain amount of laziness, or maybe you haven't found the proper motivation. You know, and I urge you to really look deep inside yourself and ask yourself if the goals that you say that you have, if those really are, you know, the goals that you want or the goals that you feel right here. But guys, you know, that's all I got to say about that today. Just think about that. And, you know, and I hope you're enjoying this this phase two of my fitness journey series so far. So, you know, don't forget to click that thumbs up button down there if you like this. If not, you know, click the thumbs up button anyway. Click the subscribe button down over here so you don't miss anything. Share this with your gym buddy. Share this with your friend. And guys, just stay tuned, and there's going to be more great stuff to come. And I hope all these videos have been motivational. I hope they've been educational. And guys, I will talk to you guys in that next video. See you later.